Assalamu alaikum, friends from Lahore. Recently, we met the managing director of Siemens Pakistan. Siemens is a very big company from Germany and has been in operation in Pakistan for decades. Markus Strohmeier is the managing director, and I asked him, what is Siemens currently doing in Pakistan?
I'm very thankful to speak to you today, and Siemens has a very long history in Pakistan, especially in Lahore. And I can tell you from 1922, where we opened our first office in Lahore, we are still here and we are flourishing. We are a company that has a very wide portfolio, which is, of course, over more than 170 years, changing over time. And digitalization is also a new theme. So we are digitalizing the industry, we are trying to optimize processes, we are trying to optimize production, to improve efficiencies. We are also a digitalization to save the consumption of energy and electricity in buildings. So everything is about optimization in that digitalization of industry's field. And also in infrastructure, Siemens is active. They want to make the infrastructure smart. Right now, the best example of all our technologies you would find in a neighboring country at Expo 2020 Dubai. We have a full portfolio applied on the campus, from building technologies to power transmission, power distribution, and low voltage. So everything from alarm system, fire alarm security, we have managed over there, command and control centers. We are very strong in buildings, making buildings smart. Again, it all comes back to data, big data. By analyzing, we can decide strategies and we can also start to act. First is to collect data, analyze it, and act. And that's a cycle, a repeating cycle, and it works 24 hours. So basically, we can save a lot of energy also in buildings and make cities run more efficiently. That is another aspect of what Siemens is. Siemens also has its own built-in consultancy, and that's called Advanta. We are guiding our customers on their journey towards digitalization. We are doing digitalization maturity assessments for customers. If you are running a factory, if you are running a larger operation, we could help you to define your roadmap of digitalization. So that's on that aspect. Other than that, Siemens is in healthcare. Of course, Siemens Healthineers is very active also in Pakistan. Let me jump to our next folks. The next folks would be in Siemens Gamesa Wind Power. We're having a very high market share on all the renewable energy wind power projects in the country. And last but not least, we are also using Lahore as a hub for our software development company that you might not associate with Siemens, but it is 100%. And it is called Mentor Graphics. We're having here more than 100 software developers exclusively exporting IT services to the US.
Of course, Siemens offers a lot of high-tech, modern technologies, talking about IT. But is Pakistan in a position to benefit from what Siemens is offering?
If you want to stay in the digitalization, definitely, because we have a lot to catch up. I believe one of the first discussions I had in the country, I was myself surprised because I thought labor is very affordable in Pakistan and there might be less drive to digitalize and automate processes. But I was told we have to make our business resilient, and we, for example, in COVID, cannot afford to not produce food, to not deliver product. People depend on it, livelihood depends on it. So we need to take this element out of our productivity or out of our risk review. We have to have processes that allow us to produce regardless if people come to work or not. We need to be able to take over. So there is a very high reason, a very strong reason to digitalize. And also, I think it speeds up a lot. And that's not only in the industry. If you look, we all are complaining governments are slow all around the world. And if you digitalize even in governments and institutions, certain processes, then you will simply earn higher speed, more transparency, traceability, and happiness of the customer ultimately, which is us, the citizens. And even there, Siemens is active. So Siemens is also the largest partner of SAP for ERP system implementations in Pakistan. And all across the board, this is, I think, a market that actually is a tipping point and increasingly interesting.
I also asked Markus Strohmeier as to what makes it difficult for major German firms to come to Pakistan or return to Pakistan, because the business environment here doesn't seem to be very conducive if you listen to German or other European business executives.
Yes, it's an interesting question, because we also recently had an AHK delegation. It's a German organization promoting foreign investment overseas, Chamber of Commerce. And we were also inviting and discussing this in the circle of Siemens and the visiting companies. I think there is a certain hurdle. And since we are already over the hurdle and we are here, we are benefiting from it because we took that step very early. And you are very right. The international choice for the companies is very big. They can choose amongst 10 or 20 potential countries to put their eggs into their basket, so to say. And it is an international battle for investment. COVID has mixed the cards to a certain degree, because all of a sudden, it's not only ease of investment, but also where is a market? There is a really rising market. And Pakistan, in my opinion, shows a rising demand and rising market. You have 220 million plus of population, and there's a lot to come. So it's the new decisions will not only be how easy is it, but how big is that market? I think Pakistan benefits to a certain degree from the current situation and pandemic. You always had unbroken value chains. I think you were very resilient as a country and not dependent on supplies from 16 international countries to finish a product, but you were having complete value chains in the country. So you're also still able to act while others have broken supply chains and can't get certain parts that allow them to finish the product. But what makes it easy or difficult for German companies to come in is a question would fill the whole afternoon, but maybe take some at their hand and help them. Siemens is a good example, but the next one will be even a better example, because a next new one who really says, yeah, that was amazing and I could start my business and come for more. You need champions, you need heroes, you need, if that's what you're lacking, then pick one where you think they have the highest impact in your country or a very high impact, and let them flourish and others will follow. And I think that was also, Siemens was a very early company in nowadays Pakistan, of course, I'm so sorry. It was already in 1874 that our guys were here. As I said, in 1922, we opened office in Lahore. So we were a very early corporate citizen. And the next one coming will decide the news, will make the social media and press releases, and then others will follow. So you need to kind of nurture your next heroes and champions. That's my opinion.
Well, that's it from Lahore, as far as this conversation with Siemens Managing Director Markus Strohmeier is concerned. And he's promising a lot. He thinks Pakistan offers a lot of potential, but conditions in Pakistan have to be made more conducive in order to attract not only German, but other foreign investors.